Live photos capture 1.5 seconds of video before and after you snap your photo. Maybe you're one of the people who use this feature, or maybe you turned it off. If you're the latter, this tutorial just might change your mind. Today, I'm going to teach you how to convert live photos back into videos. This is perfect for vacations, parties, holiday gatherings, and so much more. For example, let's say you and your friends are about to go on an amazing trip together. If everyone snaps live photos, when you're done with the trip, you can select all of them and export them as one video where each shot is 3 seconds in length. I'm telling you, this is going to totally change how you create home movies. That's coming up next on Tech Talk America. Hey folks, and welcome to the class. I'm gonna start by teaching you how to do this with a single photo, but trust me, things get exponentially cooler when you add multiple images. To convert a single live photo, simply tap on the three dots icon that you see at the top right corner of your iPhone or iPad, and then tap on Save as Video. One important detail that you should know is that it's going to save the video as the date of the photo. You might think that it would save it as the current date. It doesn't. That being said, here's an easy way to navigate to that video. Go into Albums and then tap on Recents. It'll be all the way at the bottom of the list. It should also be noted that you can do this on the Mac, but the workflow is a little bit different. All you need to do is hold down the Option key on your keyboard when you drag the photo out of the Photos app and onto the desktop or into a folder. When you do, it exports it as two files. One will be a photo and the other a video. Let's go over a few settings that I recommend you change if the event that you are going to capture has yet to take place. For starters, let's go into Settings and scroll down to the Camera app. Then let's tap on Preserve Settings. The first two items in this list that I recommend that you turn on are Creative Controls, and if you scroll all the way to the bottom, you'll see that there's an option to make live photos a default option. Real quick, the reason why I recommend turning on Creative Controls is because in just a moment, I'm going to advise you to change the aspect ratio in the camera app from 4:3 to 16:9. The reason why is all videos that are captured in landscape mode are naturally going to be in 16:9. So if you mix in content that's 4:3, you'll end up with black bars on the side. At this point, let's flip back to the camera app and do just that. Tap on the little arrow icon that you see here at the top. That will open up a bunch of extra settings at the bottom. And here in this list is 4:3, and let's change it to 16:9. My next tip is that you add the images that you want to convert into an album. The reason why is the order the images appear in the album will match the order that they appear once it's turned into a video. And of course, the great thing about an album is you can reorder your images by manually using drag and drop. If you don't put them into an album, they'll just appear in chronological order. So this way you have a little bit more creative control over the final product. You should also know when you go to select all of these live photos, you cannot have any other types of files selected, like actual videos or non-live photos. It needs to be exclusively live photos for the Save as Video menu item to appear. While you can use this technique with photos shot in portrait mode or landscape mode, my advice is to not mix the two because it will result in distortion. The next tip that I wanted to share with you is if your photo library currently looks like this, this is what we refer to as square photo grid. And for this process, I recommend that you tap the three dots icon here at the top and switch it over to aspect ratio grid. That way you can much more easily see which photos are in portrait mode and which ones are in landscape mode. Another option is you can duplicate this album and then remove all of the landscape photos. That way all you have left is an album of portrait photos. And that is perfect for posting to something like the Stories feature on Instagram or that other app that should absolutely be banned. When you've isolated all of your live photos and removed any that you want to exclude, now all we need to do is select all of the photos in this album, then go to the three dots icon and tap on Save as Video. If you do not see Save As Video in the menu, then what I would encourage you to do is to do this in smaller batches and then stitch all of those videos together in something like iMovie. When I did this for my vacation video, I noticed if I tried to do this for more than 30 photos at a time, that menu item disappeared. So if you don't see Save As Video, try doing it in smaller batches. The other option is, of course, you can do this from a Mac, in which case I had no problem exporting every single live photo all at once. The downside is that when you do this on the Mac, you end up with a separate file for every clip, as opposed to it being self-contained in one video. When you watch the video, one of the things that you will notice is that it captures the audio, and inevitably, some of these moments you will want to preserve, and others you might want to mute. So what I recommend you do is import that video into iMovie, and then you can add titles, voiceovers, a soundtrack, and of course, mute any clips that don't work. If you haven't already seen it, be sure to check out my tutorial if you want to learn more about using iMovie. Link in the video description. At this point, I'm going to show you a small clip of the video that I made in Australia, and specifically, we're going to focus on our trip to the Taronga Zoo. And what's really perfect about using this feature is that, of course, animals never stay still for you. So this way, you can capture that little bit of movement and then turn it into something like this. Keep in mind, if you ever need help with using your Mac, whether it's organizing your photos, cleaning out junk, organizing passwords, or something else, you can book a 1-hour tech therapy session with me on my website at techtalkamerica.com. Be sure to click the like button and let me know in the comments section if this video changed your mind about live photos. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.